Talking to Strangers is the latest book by Malcolm Gladwell. It deals with the consequences of judging others without really knowing or understanding the other. It covers prominent cases such as that of Sandra Bland and Bernie Madoff. It shows how little we really know about the people who live among us. We make snap judgments based on a person's appearance and behavior. Amanda Knox spent years in prison for a murder she didn't commit because Italian police saw her vivid appearance as a sign of guilt. Mistakes like this happen all the time. 1. Looking for the red flags in Fidel Castro's revenge. Ignoring warning signs while working at CIA can lead to embarrassment, betrayal, and even death. Florentino Aspilago was a Cuban intelligence agent working in Czechoslovakia. Aldrich Ames, a high-ranking U.S. agent whose duplicity led to the deaths of many non-covert agents, was ignored because of his drunken lifestyle. 2. More red flags in the Queen of Cuba. In Cuba, America is once again witnessing treachery by deceitful agents aiding Fidel Castro. In general, we tend to blindly trust those who've a good reputation. But a good reputation doesn't make a person immune to corruption, as we see time and again. 3. Why are we more likely to ignore the red flags? We rely on manners and social cues to make decisions. Personal encounters can tell us more about a person than what we read in files or on the internet. Solomon's judgments may not be as credible as he thinks. A study of more than 500,000 New York criminal cases showed that people released on bail by the machine were 25% less likely to commit a crime and more likely to appear in court compared to human judgments. 4. How we treat people that notice the red flags. While Bernie Madoff was running the largest Ponzi scheme in history, people naturally suspected. For nearly a decade, Harry Markopoulos and his team of fraud investigators kept bringing the SEC evidence of a $50 billion scheme. But each time, they were ignored. 5. Case study. The boy in the shower. It's human nature to believe that one will handle a situation differently than others. In Sandusky's case, there was too much bias toward the truth because people perceived Sandusky as a respected coach in the community. Even the victims tended to tell the truth in such an extreme situation. 6. The friend's fallacy. Dartmouth professor Jennifer Fugate analyzed facial expressions in the scene where Ross finds out that his best friend Chandler is having an affair with his sister Monica. In an episode of Friends, the audience knows exactly what the characters are feeling. Strangers in real life, however, are much harder to understand. 7. A short explanation of the Amanda Knox case. We like to think we can tell a liar by their actions, but in real life, people aren't as transparent as they seem. Amanda Knox was accused of murder even though there was no evidence linking her to the crime. The Italian police created a picture of a sex party under the influence of drugs where Courtier died. The guilt of Amanda Knox was shown in her stupid and unconventional behavior. She wasn't sad and didn't act like her friends who were also grieving for Meredith. Her behavior wasn't transparent like an episode of Friends and led to her being in prison for years. 8. Case study. The FRATERNIDY party. The case of Brock Turner and Emily Doe isn't unique. Consent becomes more ambiguous when there are no firm boundaries. Students believe that drinking alcohol brings out a person's true personality, but myopia proves that's not true. But schools should focus on teaching respect and drinking culture. 9. The case of Sandra Bland. Sandra Bland was pulled over by Brian Encina for failing to signal to change lanes. 3 days later, Bland died in police custody of an apparent suicide. It's important to remember that we can't understand strangers, and we should stop assuming that we can. The man who stopped Bland believed he saw the truth about her character. Malcolm Gladwell has successfully proven that we as humans cannot understand strangers. We've intuitions that reflect prejudices and preconceptions about strangers that are most likely wrong. Even if we think we know a person by hearsay, we're not able to truly understand the strangers who live among us. For more 5-minute book digests, check our other videos. See you soon.